analysis of the primary living examination results for 2020 that was released earlier today by the Uganda National Examinations Board and the Minister for Education. We shall be bringing you the statistics and the perspective very shortly, but let's first take a look at parents and teachers in Mityana by press time who were still jubilating following the excellent performance of pupils in the just concluded PLE results release. Parents who spoke with the news said they had lost hope because of the lockdown and the overall pandemic stress, but they were surprised by the results that came through. That and more in this wrap.
At Kosa Day and Boarding Primary School, Maria Chisache, one of the best pupils, scored 7. We phoned Chisache with her mother, Florence Nabakoza, in the stationery shop along Kampala Road in Mityana. Nabakoza, who spoke with a lot of joy, said she never expected her daughter to pass well.
Every week! Oh, Manang!
However, Chisache, whose dream is to become a journalist, was not happy with the results. She says she had expected to perform better with 4 or 5 aggregates. She, however, thanks God, her parents and teachers for enabling her get these aggregates.
My parents, I thank my mom who has been there for me since day one. I thank my teachers, Teacher Henry, thank you, Teacher Ambrose, Teacher Haboni. I can't thank enough, Director, Teacher Richard, Basa, Teacher Sarah, the two Teacher Sarahs. I can't thank enough. But God will pay you.
We are very grateful to the Lord who has made us pass well. Thanks to the parents who are interested as their children, and we continue to pray for our children to continue working hard and keep the performance for our school also in the next years.
The director of the school calls upon parents to continue looking after their children during the lockdown. Meanwhile, the mood in Fort Poto was celebratory in several homes that our reporter visited. Unlike past years, where parents and their children would flock schools searching for results and preparing to celebrate with their school teachers, it was a different situation. This time, since many were found in their homes only celebrating with family members and neighbors, Melvin Agondaza, who was found at a home washing clothes, says that she feels happy because she wasn't expecting to pass.
But for what he has done for me, I wasn't expecting it. I've been in a lot of struggle since my primary and everything. I just wanted to thank him for everything that he has done for me. I thank my teachers, my parents who have been there for me.
Isaac Marunji, who scored 10 from Toro parents, says that he got what he prayed for and had to write his wish in the Bible, and God has done it fully as expected.
I managed to get a first grade at 10. I was so prayerful. I wrote the aggregate that I wanted, I put it in the Bible. Then I said I will get it in the name of God, and I got it. It was a 10.
I got aggregate 9.
Why? How did you do it?
I got it by carrying out research, sharing with friends, asking my teachers, going visiting the library.
Eric Mugasa, the head teacher of Bohinga Primary School, said that even when the school government aided under the UPE program, they have managed to perform well, with the best pupils scoring 9.
School is a government-aided school under UP program. Concerning the results of PLOE, they were declared today by the Minister of Education. And as a school, we have managed to perform like this. We have 39 Division 1s, and Division 2, we have 170 pupils.
Relatedly, excitement rocked Future Generation Nazarene Primary School as parents and pupils in Rubanda District celebrated. Most of the successful candidates at the school are sponsored due to their vulnerability, but according to the school head teacher, George Arinaitwe, the financial challenges they have had in life did not limit their academic success.
Other stakeholders of the school, including teachers, who did a great work without being tired. My special thanks go to our beloved candidates who struggled very hard and really made it to this colorful performance.
The school had 28 candidates and 12 of them scored Division 1 in the exams. Their best candidate, Doreen Atusasire, scored 7 aggregates. Some of the successful candidates expressed joy over the victory.
I thank our sponsors who paid for our school fees. And I thank God who has given me these aggregates.
I got 8 aggregates. I thank God for having given me chance of getting 8 aggregates. I also thank our director for having bought for us test box.
I got 8 aggregates. I thank my sponsors for paying me school fees. I also thank God for having blessed me to get this aggregate.
In northern Uganda, parents, teachers and pupils are calling on government to step in and provide reading materials to all vulnerable learners in the lower classes. This comes as the PLE results were released. Sitting at her office, the director of Hilda Primary School is excited after her school scored 100% first grade.
Now, we are not able to celebrate. We are not able to reach the kids because of COVID. And we know that time will come then when we shall look onto that. However, right now, we are preparing our learners to prepare themselves for the reopening, to join the senior ones.
However, as the country seeks for ways of continuing the education of millions of learners whose progress has been halted by the COVID-19 pandemic, she believes that digital education is expensive for the majority of Ugandans in the north. Her sentiment is shared with Ernest Muhindo, a teacher of science.
In northern Uganda here, I don't think there's a school conducting even online, on a personal level of a school. Because it requires, how many of our parents can afford laptops, can afford tablets, can afford, computers. My parents, I did the need assessment, I did the baseline survey on that. I realized it cannot work.
The lower classes, I would say, we should continue to supply with them the government materials that are being written from NCDC. They're actually written by experts, and if they use them well, they are still going to pass.
Ephraim, a father and resident of Peche in Gulu City, thinks free internet should be provided by government.
Internet cost is very high in Uganda. Mm. And so the government should help where necessary.
14-year-old Onanichan Emmanuel stands next to his jubilating father. The pupil has scored 5 aggregates in the exams. His father, a border rider in the city, reflects back on tough times and the year which saw their school closed due to COVID-19 pandemic.
I should be sending like this work here, like they can send papers, send teachers can mark, then now they can do corrections.
The government should provide free newspapers and education services to the vulnerable.
And in Hoima, parents, teachers and candidates who excelled celebrated the entire day off. Some school administrators say it was a tough time to sit exams amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. In Hoima City, so far, this best school, Flobeto Nasaren Primary School, produced 90 candidates in Division 1, while only one was in Division 2.
For aggregates, I would like to thank the Almighty God for having enabled me complete my primary level successfully. I'd also like to thank my parents for paying my school fees.
Ish, I get to D1. Science, D1. Mathematics, D1. Social studies, D2. I scored those marks because I had confidence.